Hello friends, so we have been going through the ratings of the synchronous generator, and in the previous couple of sessions we have gone through the voltage, we have gone through the frequency, and then we went to the apparent power rating, and then we also saw the rated power factor of the synchronous generator. So today we are going to cover an interesting topic which is called the synchronous generator capability curves. Okay, so it's a very important topic and it took me a lot of time to think about of how to present this thing to these capability curves to you properly. Okay, so I will try to put it as simple as possible so that you understand the concept properly. Okay, so before beginning with anything, let us start by defining what is a capability curve. Okay, so what is a capability curve? So I'll just put down the definition here. So it is actually the representation. It is actually the representation of the armature and the field winding, the armature and the field windings, heating capabilities, okay, heating limits, okay, because you know that in any rating, it is usually the heating of the winding which plays the important role. So it is a representation of the armature and field winding heating limits and any other limits. And we'll understand all these things very clearly when we go through the lecture. Okay, so it is the representation of the armature and field winding heating limits and any other limits, okay, of a synchronous generator graphically. Okay, so basically, as the statement suggests, it is going to be a graph. Okay, so in our usual examples, the armature is the stator and the field winding is usually the rotor. So we can also say that it is a representation of the stator and rotor winding heating limits and any other limits of the synchronous generator graphically. Okay, now, so basically what this is that it is a complex plot. It is a complex plot. Complex in the sense, it is a complex plot of the KVA rating, that is S is equal to P plus JQ. So, because this J term comes here, that is why we call it a complex plot. It is a complex plot, S equal to P plus JQ, where P is the active power, Q is the reactive power, and S is the apparent power of the machine. These are all basic AC fundamentals. Okay. And from where do you derive it? It is derived from the phasor diagram of the synchronous generator. It is derived from the phasor diagram of the synchronous generator. So, I hope by this time of having so many lectures on synchronous generator, you should be quite familiar with the synchronous generator phasor diagram. Okay, so let us take a new page and we will draw the phasor diagram and we will continue our explanation. So you know that in the equation, you know that E angle delta is equal to V phi angle 0 plus IA angle minus theta, theta is the power factor, into RA plus J into IA angle minus theta into XS. So this is the basic equation of a phasor equation of a synchronous generator. So based on that, if you take V phi as your reference, okay, this is V phi, okay, and this is the current angle IA, assuming a lagging load. So this angle will be theta. So I'm just going to transfer it here. So in this particular explanation, what we are going to do is that we are going to neglect the IARA drop. We have done this a lot of time, even when we were deriving the steady state power limit of the synchronous generator, we have neglected this IARA drop. So we are going to neglect this IARA drop, and you know that this IA J into IA into XS will be in 90 degree with the value of IA. Okay, so this will be J into IA into XS. So this is a good revision for all of you to understand how to draw the phasor diagram. So now V phi plus J into IA into XS will give you the total value angle EA. Okay, this value will EA, and this angle is delta. Okay, this angle is delta. So this is the phasor diagram, and we are going to derive the capability curve from this particular phasor diagram. So follow very closely. So now let me put an origin point here now. So we are going to use a graph, right? So I'm going to define my origin here. So this point here, O, will be my origin point. So this point O is my origin point, and I'll just draw some more letters here. So we can divide this vector J into IA into X in two components, right? One horizontal component and one vertical component. Okay, so I'm going to define the points like this. This OA is the horizontal component. And OB AB will be the vertical component. This AB will be the vertical component and this OA is the horizontal component. Okay, so let us resolve this vector now. Now this angle is theta here. So this angle also will become equal to theta. And therefore, this angle will be 90 minus theta. Okay, so we are going to use 90 minus theta to resolve OB into OA and AB. Okay, AB will be same length as this particular length here, but it is easier to show it in this point here. Okay, so OA and AB we are going to derive here. So what will be the value of OA? OA is the horizontal component, right? So it will be equal to IA excess value into cos of 90 minus theta. Right now, cos of 90 minus theta is sin theta. So this is equal to IA excess into sin theta. Okay, and AB is the vertical component, and therefore that will be the sin component. Right. So this IA excess into sin of 90 minus theta. Right. So AB will be OB sin theta, sin 90 minus theta. So this will be equal to IA into excess into cos theta. Okay. So I hope things are clear till now. Now, because this is a graphical concept, we have to define certain points here. So O will be my origin point. So that will be 0, 0. Okay, this will be 0, 0. Now this length from this point to this point, let me call this point as X here. So the point from X to O is V face, right? This length will be V face. So because this is in the negative axis, because this is the origin point, so this side will be positive and this side will be negative. So X point will be minus V face angle 0. For the time being, let us take only these two points. Now, what I want to do in the capability diagram is that I want to convert this phasor. Now, this phasor is in volts, right? The axis is in volts. So, OA is in volts and this axis also is in volts. We want to convert this particular diagram in terms of power, that is active power, reactive power and apparent power. So what I can do is that I can use a calibration factor which I can multiply to individual terms like OA, AB, EA, then X. All these points I can multiply by a calibration factor so that this phasor diagram in volts will convert into power. So our objective is to find what is the calibration factor. Okay. Now, what is P? The value of P is equal to 3 into V phase IA cos theta, right? Theta be the power factor angle. Okay. Now, if I want to convert some quantity into power here, that is VI into cos theta, which will I select? Will I select OA or will I select AB? You can see that in OA, you are having sin theta. Okay. So, that is not going to be a good result. But in AB, we are having cos theta here. Okay. So, in AB, we are having cos theta. So, I can multiply this with some value so that I will get power. Okay. So, with what quantity should I multiply? If I multiply it by 3 into V phase divided by XS. Okay, 3 V phase divided by XS. So, what will I get here? So, this XS and this XS will go. So, I will get 3 V phase IA cos theta. Okay, so I will get 3 V phase IA into cos theta. So, if I multiply AB, okay, if I multiply AB by a factor of 3 V phase by XS, I will get P value. So, I will just write down that. So, AB in volts was equal to IA excess into cos theta, right? So, when I multiply it by 3 into V phase divided by excess, I get AB in terms of what power? In terms of active power. Active power P. So, I will just put it as A dash B dash just to make a difference. So, A dash P dash will be equal to 3 V phase IA cos theta. I have done nothing. I have just multiplied a term so that AB in terms of voltage will convert into AB in terms of power. Okay. Similarly, I can multiply OA also. Let us see what will we get when we multiply OA. OA in terms of volts, OA in terms of volts, you can see that it is IA into XS into sin theta. Right. So, if that also I multiply by 3 V phase divided by XS, 3 V phase divided by XS, I will get O dash A dash. Okay. And let us see what is that value here. Okay. So, I will just put it in the side here somewhere. So, IA XS sin theta multiplied by 3 V phase divided by XS. Okay. So, XS, XS will go. So, this will become 3 V phase IA into sin theta. Right. So, OA dash O dash A dash is nothing but 3 V phase IA sin theta. And what is this? This is the reactive power of the system. So OA dash, O dash A dash will give you the reactive power of the system. So what it means is that this 3 V phase by XS is the calibration factor which I can use to multiply each and every term in this voltage graph, and I will get a corresponding power equivalent in another graph. Okay. So let us multiply each and every term and let us see what all we get. And correspondingly, we will convert this graph into a power graph as well. So we'll just move to the next page and let us write this more neatly. Now, I have put everything neatly down here. So we have already converted OA and AB in terms of the reactive power and the active power of the system. Now let us take the third point, which is X here. Now X is nothing but the point X was minus V phase angle 0. So if you multiply this by 3 V phase divided by XS, what will you get? We will get a value X dash, which will be equal to minus 3 V phase square divided by XS, right? Simple mathematics, 3 V phase by XS into minus V phase. So that is over. Now this vector EA is there. The vector EA is there. So we will call that vector as XB, right? That vector is XB, and that value was equal to EA, right? And that you are multiplying by 3 V phase by XS. Why we are multiplying by 3 V phase by XS? Because that is the calibration factor which will help to convert this volt into power. Okay. So X dash B dash will be equal to 3 V phase EA divided by XS. Okay. And this value is usually called as DE. As per Chapman, this value he calls it as DE. Now, the remaining one value is this OB value here, OB. Okay. So OB is what? OB is nothing but IA into XS, right? OB value, absolute value is IA into XS. So that if you multiplied by 3 V phase divided by XS, so this cross sign is multiplication. Don't convert it with X. Okay. So O dash B dash, I can write it as, so 3 V phase by XS into IA into XS, right? So 3 V phase by XS divided by XS into IA into XS, right? So if you multiply these two, you will get 3 V phase into IA. So 3 into V phase into IA is nothing but the apparent power of the system. Okay. So O dash A dash gave you Q, A dash B dash gave you P, and O dash B dash is going to give you S. So let us convert all these things into a new phasor diagram in terms of power, right? So that is going to be important for us here. So I'll just put my origin here now. Okay. So this is my point O dash, right? O dash. O dash is represented by 0 angle 0. Now, first value is OA. Let us take this OA. OA became O dash A dash. So I will put that here. This became O dash A dash. And this value was equal to how much? This value is nothing but the reactive power of the system. Okay, reactive power of the system. The next one value was A dash AB, right? So AB became A dash B dash, right? AB became A dash B dash. So I'll put that point here. So this is B dash. Okay. And this value was the active power of the system. This value was the active power according to our derivation. Now, what was O dash B dash here? So O dash B dash, this value here, O dash B dash is nothing but the apparent power of the system, right? It is nothing but the apparent power of the system. Okay. So this is the point here. Now, let us mark the point X dash now. So X is minus V phase angle 0. So X becomes X dash and it becomes minus 3 V phase square divided by XS. So this value is X dash. I'll put it in a different class. So X dash value is equal to minus 3 V phase square by XS comma 0. Okay. So this was our V vector previously, and this vector looks like this now. Okay. So I'm not putting the IA vector. If you want, you can put the IA vector just for showing that. Okay. And this angle was theta. Okay. Now, finally, the value X dash B dash, right? X dash B dash will be something like this. And this value I told, it was called as DE, and that is equal to 3, this value. This value is equal to 3 V phase EA divided by XS. Okay. So if you want, we can just show these all things by some lines here. So this value is Q, this value is P, this value is S. So this O dash B dash is S, and finally you are having all these values here. So let's take all these diagrams separately and let us draw a neat diagram and see. So now let us draw the same diagram once again so that we can avoid the cluttering which we saw in the previous diagram. So let us start by drawing the origin, right? Let us start by drawing the origin, and that point was O dash, and origin will not change, right? It is always 0 angle 0. Okay, so this point here was x dash, and that value was how much? It is minus 3 v phase square divided by xs comma 0, right? So this was this value here, so x dash o, and then you had this value here o dash b dash, and this represents the apparent power of the system, and this value here x dash b dash, this represents the value which is called de, and this point O dash A dash, this represented the reactive power of the system, and this value represented the active power of the system, and this angle is theta. And if you want, you can just show the current vector here like this and just show it. Okay, so we are converting only volts into power. Okay, so this is the diagram which we will use to draw the generator capability curve. I think this much amount of information will take some time to digest. Okay, so see this video once or twice, and the next video I will draw the generator capability diagram using all this information. Okay, so till I see you in the next video, it's me Varun signing off, and have a great day, and don't forget to subscribe the channel and watch the other courses like engineering circuit analysis, DC machines and AC machinery fundamentals, and synchronous generator which is running in the channel. Okay, so till I see you in the next video, it's me Varun signing off, and have a great day. Thank you.